Safety data sheets, or SDSs, are your go-to documents when it comes to understanding hazardous chemicals. They are standardized documents providing detailed information about hazardous chemicals as mandated by OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard. They're packed with essential information that can help keep you safe. Chemical manufacturers and importers are required to create an SDS for every hazardous chemical they produce or bring into the country. As for employers, it's their job to make sure these SDS are easily accessible for any chemical used in the workplace. For employees who move between multiple work locations during their shift, the SDS can be stored at a primary workplace as long as it's readily available whenever needed, such as electronic accessibility. Quick access to this information can make all the difference when dealing with hazardous chemicals. Each SDS is organized into a consistent 16-section format, making it easy to find what you need when you need it. Let's break down an example SDS for propane, a common chemical used for many applications. Section 1, Identification. This section provides the basic details. For propane, you'd find the product name, any common synonyms like LP gas, and how it's typically used. You'll also see the manufacturer's name, contact info, and an emergency number for urgent situations. Section 2, Hazard Identification. Here's where things get serious. You'll see hazard pictograms like the flame for flammables, and the gas cylinder for compressed gas. The signal word danger lets you know that propane poses a high level of risk. Hazard statements like extremely flammable gas and may explode if heated are included, along with safety precautions to minimize accidents. Section 3, composition information on ingredients. This section lists what's in the product, including any impurities or additives. Here you see that propane makes up 80 to 100% of the product. Section 4, first aid measures. In case of exposure, this section tells you exactly what to do. For propane, if it contacts someone's eyes, the SDS recommends flushing the affected eyes in lukewarm water and seek immediate medical attention. Section 5, firefighting measures. Propane is highly flammable, so this section outlines the best way to fight fires involving the chemical. You'll find recommendations for using dry chemical or carbon dioxide extinguishers and advice on the protective equipment firefighters should use. Section 6, accidental release measures. If there's a spill or leak, this section offers guidance on how to safely manage it, protecting both people and the environment. With propane, we see extremely flammable. Spillages of liquid product will create a fire hazard and may form an explosive atmosphere. Section 7, handling and storage. This section gives practical advice on how to handle and store propane. It highlights that propane is heavier than air and can accumulate in low areas like basements. Proper storage is critical to avoid dangerous gas buildup. Section 8, exposure controls and personal protection. To keep you safe, this section lists exposure limits and what personal protective equipment, or PPE, you should use, like thermal insulating gloves or eye or face protection. Section 9, physical and chemical properties. Want to know more about propane? This section provides detailed information, such as its colorless appearance, that there is no distinct odor unless an odorant is added, and the boiling point is minus 44 degrees Fahrenheit. Section 10, stability and reactivity. Here you'll find details on propane stability and how it might react under different conditions. For example, avoid all possible sources of ignition. Heat will increase pressure in the storage tank. Section 11, toxicological information. This section dives into the potential health risks of propane exposure, such as it's being a simple asphyxiant. Sections 12 through 15, while not required by OSHA, provide additional valuable insights. Section 12, ecological information. Propane's impact on the environment. Here you see that petroleum gases will readily evaporate from the surface and would not be expected to have significant adverse effects in the aquatic environment. Section 13, disposal considerations. This section explains how to safely dispose of a chemical and its packaging, outlining recommended methods, regulatory requirements, and environmental precautions. Since propane is a gas, it would not typically be managed as a waste, but proper handling of empty cylinders is still essential to prevent leaks or hazards. Section 14, transport information. This section outlines regulations for safely transporting propane as a 2.1 hazard class. Section 15, regulatory information. Learn about any laws or regulations that apply to propane, such as those falling under California's Proposition 65. Finally, Section 16, other information. This section wraps it all up with the date of the SDS preparation or its most recent revision, along with any extra notes or disclaimers. In workplaces where complex mixtures are used, meaning the chemical ingredients are similar but with slight variations, the manufacturer or employer may create a single SDS that covers all these mixtures. And if a chemical contains components that are trade secrets, those details might not be listed, but all relevant safety information will still be included to ensure safe handling. Remember, the safety data sheet is an essential tool for staying safe around hazardous chemicals. Always take a moment to review the SDS before handling any chemicals so you fully understand the risks and how to protect yourself.